Hello everyone and welcome. In this video, we will be renovating and finishing an old uncompleted 5-bedroom house in McCarthy Hill. Work on this building began around 2011-2012, but stalled at some point due to a myriad of reasons. We at Jacob West were contracted in the latter part of 2019 to complete this project. We did an assessment of the property and realized some issues that needed to be addressed. One of these issues was a sharp wicket slope in the living dining room that needed to be leveled. Some of the rooms needed to be modified to include an ensuite, and the dining hall needed to be raised a few inches, as did the kitchen. Another issue was that the blocks that was used for the buildings were not of the best quality. We also proposed a redesign of the building to make it more modern and contemporary. This meant the removal of all the arches, since arches are mainly associated with classical type of building designs. This is what our proposed redesign looks like in 3D. This is the look and finish that we are going for. Before we continue, kindly give this video a like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Also, if you have any questions and comments, kindly leave them in the comment section below. With our proposed designs approved, we began work. On the inside, we mounted our formworks for the dining area and kitchen. With the formwork done, we filled these areas with sand, which is what you see here. The plan was to raise the dining area and kitchen to eliminate that wicked slope in the building. Expansion and modification works for some of the rooms also began. There were also two smaller rooms at the back that were also merged into one slightly larger room with its own toilet and bath. Similar modifications were also made to the rooms at the top. Now we move to the exterior. The first thing that we did was to close up the arc and make the window and doors flat at the top. Work on the carport in front of the building also began. We excavated the earth where the columns will be and started installing our beams. In this shot, you can see The arch at the entrance has been almost removed and columns for the carports have also been mounted with casting ready to begin. Casting of the columns is now ongoing. Columns have been cast and the arch of the main front entrance has been removed completely. You can now see the formwork being done for the top of the carport, which will also double as a terrace. Formwork now completed, steel work can begin for the top of the carport. Reinforcement work is still ongoing for the carport. We also decided to close up part of the entrance to the terrace. This was to make our entrance much smaller to accommodate a single glass door instead of the double glass door. With all these modifications done, we now proceed to plaster the walls, starting internally and working our way out to the exterior walls. We tend to plaster all open areas before we dress the door and window frames. Thank you. can see plastering work ongoing at the back of the house. Even though we are not done with the work, you can see the design gradually coming to the fore. Screeding has now begun. We're doing the final bit of plastering for the carport. With the work on the main building done, we proceed with our fence wall. The excavator was used to level the area around the house, and then we began excavating the ground for our wall. You may be asking yourself, why are we going through the hassle of putting too much effort into our fence wall? The reason for this is the location of our house. The house is located on a hill. This means runoff rainwater comes down with a lot of force. This means that if our wall is not done properly, it might collapse when it rains heavily. Engineering is always important when it comes to building and construction of any major or minor structure. Knowing and understanding good engineering is the difference between a good structure that stands for centuries and one that becomes a death trap. You can now see our beam base conveniently installed in the trench. This is going to serve as the solid foundation for our wall. reinforcement is placed between the inner and outer walls. We will mount our formwork and cast the section in the middle to completely strengthen our wall. You can now see the wall taking shape. If you look at the main building, you will also see that the windows have been installed for all the rooms. We are now plastering the main fence wall. As you can see, all the work for this stage has been completed, and this is what the house looks like now. The next stage is to begin finishing work, and this is ceilings, wiring, tiling, painting, plumbing, and landscape. With that, we've now come to the end of this video. If you have any questions or suggestions, you can leave them in the comment section below, and we'll try our best to respond to them. If you found this video helpful, you can also leave us a like and kindly subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. We look forward to seeing you in the next video. Until then, stay safe. Cheers.